Okay, we're looking at cubic functions next. So any function where the highest power is 1, we've known that as a linear function. Any power which is 2, we've called that a quadratic function. Now we say any power that's 3 is called a cubic function. And just to be, not to be silly, 4 is called a quartic and 5 is called a quintic. And then after that, they don't have names. But the only ones you basically study are the first three in any depth in mathematics. But a cubic just means the highest power is 3, okay? So in this video, we're going to be looking at just the really straightforward one, y equals x cubed, y equals minus x cubed, y equals some number of x cubed, and y equals some number of x cubed plus or minus a number. So a can be a plus or minus number, and b can be a plus or minus number. So they're the ones we're going to look at in this graph, in this video. Come across when you're ready. Okay, so I'll get some colors. So y equals x cubed. If you go to Desmos, you can plot these yourself just to make sure that you're not, I'm not telling you any lies. But y equals x cubed. It's an odd power function and it finishes like that. Okay, it's positive, so it finishes in a positive direction. Okay, and that's the shape of x cubed. So you can, so for instance, 1 cubed is 1, 2 cubed is 8. Minus 2 cubed is minus 8. Okay, so that's how I got the graph. Okay, if you look at minus x cubed, it goes the other way. It's a minus, so it finishes in a minus direction. Okay, so that's the basic ones. So if I put a number in front, it's still the same shape. But it just means, so for instance, that x equals 1, instead of it equaling 1, 2 times 1 equals 2. And at x equals 2, instead of going to 8, it goes to 16. So if I put them over the top of each other, they would definitely look different, but they're it is the same shape, okay? And the same with this last one. So like for instance, going back here, for x equals 1, 1 cubed is 1, but it'd be a minus 1. So at x equals 1, 1 cubed is 1, so it'd be a minus 4. So if you put these guys over the top of each other, they wouldn't sit on top of each other, but the basic shape is the same. And if you use Desmos, go on and just plot those ones, you can see exactly what's happening as well. Okay, copy and come across. Okay, so now I'm putting in numbers at the back. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll just graph. Okay, so that would be y equals 2x cubed. So it goes through the origin at x equals 1, that would be equal 2. So what happens is, every single point on the green line is going to be dropped by 1. So it's going to be sort of parallel. So instead of crossing at 0, it's going to cross at minus 1. And when x equals 1, instead of going through at 2, it'll go through at 1. But basically, it's parallel to the first line, okay, and just drop down 1 point. So again, so that is minus 3x cubed, and then we're going to just bump it up by 2. So instead of going through at 0, it goes through at 2. And if you wanted to find that point, we could solve it by an equation. So minus 3x cubed plus 2 equals 0. 3x cubed, make that a plus, equals 2. X cubed equals 2/3, so x equals the cube root of 2/3, and that would be that answer there. That answer for that number there, it'd be 2x cubed minus 1 equals 0, 2x cubed equals 1, x cubed equals 1/2, x equals the cube root of 1/2, and that would be that number there. Okay. that's the end of the first video on straightforward cubics. See you next time.